I was just speaking about Mexico City and how large Mexico City has grown. It has not grown to the size it is simply through birth. In fact, the primary reason Mexico City has grown to the size it is because of migration. So, why do people migrate, and what is migration? Migration is just simply moving from one place to another for a whole variety of reasons. Two things cause people to move. One, we categorize as push factors. These are the things that cause people to leave a place, so they're pushing them away. And the other is pull factors. This draws people to a place. Let's start with the push factors. There's going to be three push factors and three pull factors. The first of the push factors is a political reason or political reasons. One of these could be a war. Obviously, if you stay where you're at and there's a war going on, you may very well die. Another is a lack of freedom and democracy. It should be no surprise that over the last several decades, people have gotten on rickety crafts and attempted to get from Cuba to the United States. It's not like people are getting on rickety crafts in Florida and trying to get to Cuba. Religious persecution. We've seen this going on in the Middle East, amongst other places. Ethnic persecution, also something that's going on in the Middle East and other places. Ideological reasons. You have particular political views, and who's ever in charge has different political views, and you're persecuted for those reasons. Here's some more push factors. Economic reasons people leave. The primary one is poverty. Where you live, you're poor. Everybody around you is poor. Everybody has always been poor. When you look in the crystal ball, you see poverty. So leave. No hope for betterment. No, as far as you can tell, ability to better your lot in life. Lack of educational opportunities. Maybe even lack of or a poor healthcare system could cause people to leave. And one more push factor, environmental reasons. You can see this is small, so there's going to be a number of them. Weather and climate. So this is a reason, for example, that the Northeast and the upper Midwest of the United States has been draining people for 50 years because the winters can be very rough. Natural disasters can cause people to leave. Things like hurricanes. Think about what happened to Louisiana. Earthquakes could happen in California. Flooding happens all over the place. Fires can drive people out. Mudslides can cause people to leave. And famine can cause people to leave. Now, famine might be environmental, but it could also be political, depending on whether it's manipulated by a government or not. Pull factors are going to draw people to a place, and we're going to have the three same types of pull factors that we had with push factors. So there are political reasons that people are drawn to a place. Freedom and democracy is one of the most obvious ones. Say what you want, read what you want, do what you want, vote. Religious tolerance. If you belong to a religious minority in a place where religious minorities are not tolerated, leaving might be a good idea and going to a place where people are not so concerned about your religion. Ethnic acceptance. Here's some more pull factors. Economic reasons. Perception of economic possibilities. This has historically been one of the great draws of the United States. People perceive that if they come to the United States, they are going to make more money. Educational opportunities. You may very well get into Harvard. If you live in California and you get into Harvard, you're going to be drawn to Harvard and to Massachusetts because of the educational opportunities. It doesn't have to be international. Job opportunities. Healthcare. Not every state in the United States has the same healthcare system. And one more pull factor, environmental reasons. Weather and climate. This is the reason that the southeast of the United States and the western part of the United States have drawn people over the last 4 or 5 decades because the climate is easier to live in. Or location near physical amenities, like living near the ocean. Or if you like the mountains, living in the mountains for fishing and hiking. Or clean air. Or simply solitude. As Americans, we all have a story of migration and immigration. Here's mine. On my mother's side, my family left Ireland in the 1850s because of the famine that happened in the late 1840s. This was both a political push factor and an environmental push factor to leave because, yes, it was an environmental disaster, but the British government didn't help it. And in fact, they probably exacerbated it. And they came to the United States and lived in eastern Pennsylvania. So there was a political pull factor because they felt like they would not be starved to death in the United States, and an economic pull factor because they felt like they would have jobs. Then they worked in eastern Pennsylvania in the coal mines until the 1930s when the Depression happened. And then at the end of the 1930s, my mother's family moved to Buffalo, New York, because the war began to happen in Europe and the factories in Buffalo were opening up and people were having jobs. And so there was an economic push from the closed coal mines and an economic pull to Buffalo because jobs had opened up. And my mother became a nurse during World War II. And one day she was walking outside of her house, her apartment, to go to work during the winter, and she slipped on ice and fell and broke her arm. And she said, "I don't want to live any place where I'm going to slip and break my arm on ice." And so she moved to Long Beach, California. And when she moved to Long Beach, California, she knew the climate would be better here. My uncle already lived here. And so there was an environmental push and an environmental pull. Then for me, I went to school in the United States. I was born in California, and I couldn't get a job when I got out of college in Southern California. And so I moved to Northern Illinois, where I got a job. And I worked there for 1 year. And after that 1 year, I moved back to Long Beach because I got a job at Santa Ana College. So there was an economic push from Southern California to Illinois and an economic pull to Illinois. And then there was an economic pull back to Southern California, combined with, I would say, an environmental pull because it was no fun living in the winter in Illinois. What's your story?